That's what we are about.
Can you hear us? Hey, ni ame drop. Gloria, Mike ni yako bas. Your hand is up. Gloria, karibu comrade. Can you hear me? Gloria, Daniel, unanisikia?
Is it me?
Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you so much, Afrocentric, and good morning to all of us here. For me, it's about what happened yesterday, these nominations. And I
Afro, can I go so I can go to work and continue as a listener? Can you guys hear me?
I'm speaking.
Mebs, can you go after Gloria? Can you hear Gloria speaking?
I can't hear her.
Oh, Gloria was speaking. I'll call upon you to go after Gloria, okay, Mebs? Gloria, Malaysia. I mean, go ahead.
Okay. So mi nasema hii pain yenye tunafeel, we keep feeling pain all the time and I'm not understanding it. From the word go, we kept saying these politicians are the same. We expected them to regroup, and we were seeing it. And every spaces that I've been talking, I've been telling people, if you want to know what is going to happen, just look at what the government bloggers are saying. And in the last 1 week, the Kalumas, you saw how they were really fighting for this thing. So it was all expected, my people, to see distracted by every little thing these people are saying. Sisi tukue goal yetu ni Ruto must go, and we already defined it. Ruto must go is the system that has to go and has to sweep everyone. We are draining the swamp. So tusikue distracted na vitu ndogo ndogo. Tusikue distracted. It doesn't matter who gets into that cabinet, whether the ODM people got in, whether who, it doesn't matter, because it is that incompetence, yeah, politicians that we are fighting. Because why would you remove someone from parliament when there are other people out here? And then you are claiming there is no money, but how many by-elections are those? Three people from parliament. I mean, how many by-elections are those that you are talking about, yet you are claiming there is no money in the country? So let's just look at these people like for who they really are. And it's not the first time Raila is betraying us. I don't know why we are crying. It's not the first time. The man handshook Uhuru. The man entered into a Mnusumkate government with Kibaki, who killed people. I mean, like, it's not the first time, people. It's not. Let's not keep bemoaning things that do not need us to mourn. And so most people have now dropped the hashtag. If you go online, people look confused, crying over, I don't know, Raila this, Raila that. I mean, really. Let us not be distracted. These people, we already said they will regroup. Politicians, they are there for self-preservation. They are not there for the common mwananchi. They have never been, and they will not start being today. So let's be on course. Let's be on course. Let's not waste our time, because the more we bemoan these issues, the more we get infiltrated. Now people are just there throwing the tribal card, throwing the tribal.
Mnamsikia?
No.
Amezimisha mic ya speaking.
I'm a drop, Cindy.
We can't hear anymore.
You can't hear me. Hello.
Okay, Gloria, finish up. Wind up, wind up.
Okay, my thing is, someone who does not act in the best interest of the Constitution cannot be fought by the Constitution. Those who want to try the Constitution, they are welcome. But wasikuje tena kutuambia sisi whose way is demonstration atisijuo re-strategize. No. Let them try their strategy if that is what they want. But the rest of us should remain on course. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Gloria, for your submission.
If I can land kindly,
can you wait, Mems, to go? She's about to check into work, and then you go. You go next.
Okay, no problem.
Mems?
Thank you. Can you guys hear me? Unfortunately, sorry for the introduction before. I couldn't hear Gloria. I didn't hear her word she said. Okay, thank you. So, first of all, order of the day, RIP to all comrades who we've lost until right now. May their blood never be spilled in vain, and we will always remember them. And it's such a pity that ODM and UDA are getting married and walking on the aisle of the spilled blood. So, guys, like the speaker before me said, it's a long walk to freedom. Yes, guys, I always say this, it's a marathon, not a sprint. So do not lose hope. And I know we wake up every day with new news. Yesterday, we were more furious at Raila Odinga. Instead of even Ruto must go, now we are like ODM and all that. ODM can do bloody hell what they want to do. If they want and dance on our graves, let them go do it. We are partyless, and we do not need a party to ask for good governance. People who are coming here and saying, we want a leader, we need to do this, this is not a political fight. That is why our incompetent president, who is not intelligent enough to see this, is settling political scores. He thinks, oh, if I reward this party, then I'm at least safe. I can rescue my ship from sinking. But what he doesn't know is that the ship is still sinking. The lower part of me struggled with that. The ship is still sinking, and this sellotape that they're trying to just pack the ship with is not gonna work. So you cannot appoint incompetent people because you are rewarding political parties. Those dockets are not political positions. Those are actually, those are managerial positions. You cannot just give me as Mabel a docket in mining and I have no idea. Yeah, this is what we are fighting for. We are saying we want competent people. Yeah, what will Joho cannot even define the word mining. Maybe from yesterday he could. Yeah, but he cannot go and really manage that docket and have a plan for it, and maybe a 5-year plan, and say this is what we are going to do, this is what it's going to bring. Those are just corrupt leaders, and this is what we are fighting, this is what we are insisting. Guys, I know there is a lot coming from the side, the incompetent police that surely are arresting kids. We've spoken about this time and time again. You cannot arrest a minor. I mean, somebody below 18, you ought to call their guidance. You ought to call their parents. What is this? What country is this? But this is all, it starts from the top. That's why we say Ruto must go, and we need to keep the hashtag aligned. We need to be aligned, like one of the speakers before me said, aligned in one message, in one accord, in one people, one Kenya. This is what we want. One, Ruto must go. We insist. With Ruto must go, all these other sideshows, we are dealing with them from top going trickling down. Yeah, if you've seen the other side show right now, the governors are being are being audited. It's actually just a comedy club. Yeah, because they cannot account for 12 million. They cannot account for, those are just random numbers they're throwing there. This is not the Kenya we want. We want a Kenya that a child in Samburu country has the same opportunities as someone living in Kayole, and someone living in Kayole has the same opportunity with someone living in the borders in Dadaab. Is Dadaab in Kenya? No, there, somewhere there. That is what we want, and this is what we are fighting for. We do not need to be political. We do not need to be a political party. So everybody who is coming to this platform and telling us, form a political party, then we can fight these people at the ballot. To be accountable, you do not need to be a politician to ask for accountability. It's only until right now, Raila has been doing it. That is why people are mad at him. That is why we thought it was him we are listening to, but we are not our fathers. We don't say, Baba, akisema imetosha. We read for ourselves. We question these things. We question the church. We do not just follow the church blindly. Yeah, pastors who defile kids, and then we just on Sunday clap for them when they stand at the pulpit. No, we do not do that. So, guys, kindly, please, do not detest from this fight. let's keep soldiering on. One day tutafika. But again, like the speakers of before me have already spoken about this, it's not a sprint. It's not tomorrow. We are going to achieve this at the end of the day. Guys, keep pushing. Yeah, keep pushing. Just know that politics, please do not give up, because politics, really, it's a body that governs a lot of how we live our day-to-day lives. Yeah, the middle class is just a disease away from poverty. Yeah, and the poor people anyway, even dispensaries don't work, Kwamta. Yeah. So you can imagine what that is. Guys, keep pushing on. And yeah, again, follow the law. Because you remember, prison is meant for poor people. Do not use violence. Do not use... That's why somebody who stole cuckoo can go to prison for 10 years, and somebody who stole billions can never even set foot on court even for his trial. So guys, please, we follow the law and we will win this fight. And please, all these sideshows of ODM and other, we were never anyway part of ODM. If you are a registered party there, maybe you just need to deregister and then that's it. Those are all sideshows. Let's keep pushing off. Afro, thank you very much for your time, for your platform, and you always really do this. That chic, Daniel, thank you for your time, for co-hosting. Guys, have a good day. Soldier on. Do not give up. I'll continue as a listener now.
Thank you so much, Mebs. Powerful points. Abdul, you're there? Go ahead.
Yeah, yes, I'm here. I'm sorry, I had some power outage and Wi-Fi went away, but I'm now sorted. I started by thanking you for the platform before I went out. And I started by saying we are all we got. We need to keep encouraging each other and supporting each other and thanking each other for the efforts we are making. And also following each other on this platform so that our voices can be amplified. And then I went and said, the topic says about an unholy alliance between the UDA and ODM. And I said it is unholy because they have blood in their hands. They have blood in their hands because they are dancing on our graves, on the graves of the patriots that we have lost in the clamor for reforms in order to make our society a free society, free of corruption, and based on merit, so that anyone can arise from anywhere and become anything they want. And then I said, we are deeply betrayed by Raila Odinga. He has betrayed our cause as the youth of this country, because I do not believe that Joho has been appointed in order to investigate the minerals that Paulo Kimani has been unearthing, the scandals about the conservancies by Wazungus and the ownership of the parks, and why it is inaccessible to so many of our countrymen and women. I do not believe that Wandai has been appointed in order to lower the cost of electricity, to lower the cost of gas, cooking gas, to 600 per 6 kg cylinder. I believe he's there to serve a partisan interest, especially Spectre International and the rest of the companies that are associated with their party. I also do not believe that Mbandi has been appointed in order to offer compensation for the victims of police brutality, the Rex Masai's, Credo Yaro, all the people that we have lost, including the young Onyango kid that we lost. He has been appointed in order to continue ensuring their financial interests are catered for 2027 campaigns. I also do not believe that these four, including Oparanya, the SMEs are coming to empower young people, because they, first of all, they criticized the UDA bottom-up economic transformation agenda, that the bottom-up Aslas manifesto that they came. And in democracies, Afro, you've lived outside Kenya and you know, you cannot imagine a situation where the Republicans in the US campaign, then Trump wins, and then he invites over Kina Kamala Harris to come and implement the Republican manifesto. It is not even unheard of because these people have ideological differences. Some believe in even, they believe in foreign policy, they believe even in abortions, they believe in even in migrations. For example, the left believe in opening up the gates of the boundaries of the US, but the conservatives and the Republicans believe that you need to close and make it as authoritarian, as an American, as a white affair issue as much as you can. The same way for Labour Party, the way it has won in the UK, at now they extend an olive branch and say, now you conservatives come, because they don't even believe that the immigrants from Rwanda are supposed to be returned back in Kenya, in Rwanda. But the conservatives believe it is a white man affair, it is supposed to be a UK affair only and all that. So basically, we have let these people form even political parties that are not based on ideologies, whereby someone can examine their conscience and say, I have been appointed to these positions, but based on this, the matter of principle, my values and what I stand for politically and philosophically do not align to this particular movement, and I cannot go there and implement. How are we going now to see, how are we even going to see now Oguda defending bottom-up economic policies and taxation? If we have seen as a chair of PAC Mbadi opposing increase of taxes, how are we sure we are going to see at now Mbadi again increasing taxes and getting the and getting extra loans and the way they've condemned it? So what I'm saying is we need to organize ourselves and be aligned and be disciplined. I do not believe that we have lost the hope yet. I believe that those who died along the way still owe us, and they expect that we are not going to rest, and their spirits are not going to rest until we achieve at least political freedom to liberate our people, because sahi politicians were made to align. So my position and my request, kindly, let us unite and let us organize around ideologies zenye zilitufanya tuende kwa streets. Let us occupy those streets na tusitoke. Let us ensure that we achieve reforms zenye tunataka, because I feel we are on our own. We got our own. Let us support each other. Let us minimize in fighting amongst ourselves. Ndo sasa tuweze hata ku come up na a serious strategy ya ku liberate country pamoja. So in the coming weeks, mimi na support leo tuende we lay flowers kwa mahali hawa sasa walishutiwa, to present hizo petitions, to make it impossible for us to forget the people that gave themselves for ourselves. Kabisa wase tusi give up, and let us go and support these families that they are taking their flowers kwa wenye watoto wao waliuliwa. This, in fact, to take over power, nataka one day to build that a mausoleum wenye mimi watoto wangu, my unborn kids, nikiwapeleka nawaambia, these are our Nelson Mandelas of this world. This is where, yani nawapeleka nawaambia hawa wase walishutiwa mahali kama hapa, na walikuwa nataka umse mwenye ni maskini atarai someday anatakuwa kitu cha maana. So thank you so much, Afro, for the platform. Let us continue supporting each other, and let us continue encouraging each other. Niko sure tutasucceed wase. Asante sana.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Abdul. Unbowed, uncowered, fearless. Fearless, guys, let us retweet the space, and hashtag is Ruto must go. Let other Kenyans come in here and know that we, our morale is still up, we are still injecting, the pressure is still maintained. Just because Ruto has decided to have an unholy alliance with ODM and has rewarded ODM bigwigs, positions, the deputy party chair, the party chair, the minority whip positions, we are not on board with the political class of the day. We need technocrats in those positions, not rewarding non-criminals those positions. We are going to fix Kenya, and we'll be on the streets, and I'm calling for daily protests. Me niko daily protests until Ruto resigns. Every day maandamano. Kwa sababu hii pressure tuyaweke ya, they are strategizing, wanapumzika, wananunua more canister tear gas, na wanakuja wanatupiga tena. We need to daily. Hadi Ruto loses control, aseme, I resign. The presidency, the entire presidency resigns. Anyway, let me give the microphone to Ney and then Western in that order. Nay, and then Western in that order. Nay, are you there? Can you hear me?
I hope you mind fixed. I can hear you. Karibu Kumbrit. Habari zenu nyote. I hope mmemka salama.
Tujambo.
I know the spirit is a little bit low due to what happened in Zimmarman, Githurai, you know, in our brothers' houses and sisters' houses. Leo niko na machache. Sina mingi, ni machache. La kwanza ni jana ndo nilirealize ya kuwa these Ruto and his friends actually don't know what governance means, what being a servant to the people means, what being actually umekuja kutetea umma, umekuja kufanyia kazi umma. He does not know that, and they don't know that. And you know why? Is because our watu wote, very few walipita through proper ways, kura wise. Wengi wao kura ziliibiwa. So sisi hapa tu najipiga kifua nasema, oh, mnafaa kufuata constitution, oh, mnafaa kutusikiza, oh. Wao wanashanga, mnaongea nini na si nyinyi mlituleta hapa. It's our crooked ways that brought us up where we are. So to them, we are nothing. We are just like nzi ama... mambo kwenye sikio linafanya zzz, but they are trying to swat us because they don't have you crooked ways and my crooked and my bring me where I am, you know. So they have zero idea about governance. They don't care about governance. They're there to stay. They're proper thieves. They're proper vagabonds. Like, these people, they should have never been around any type of politics. They don't know what this is. Not whatever they're doing, it's not even politics. And I am seeing people saying, oh, ati Ruto is a brilliant politician, ati amepatia ODM kamba watajinyonga because of the position they've. No, they are just proper crooks, period. And that's why they have to go. Whether they go now, whether they go then, whether they go whatever, they have to go now. I don't know, then I've forgotten her name. She just spoke like 5 minutes ago. She said there's so many sideshows happening and everything. Here's the thing. This is such a big elephant, and we need, and the elephant has just grown bigger with this stupid mzee joining this group of cohorts of people they're just literally crazy. So these sideshows should be there. They should not stop, because you see, this side Shukamaya, this guy who spoke about the airport, it has brought so much light into that we never even realized, we never even knew. This sideshow of mining that is happening on the side, we never even knew about these things until, you know, someone found interest in that and started speaking about that. So this sideshow, they should still continue, but the message is still the same. Ruto must go. Him, his people, everything must go, so that we start afresh. And I also agree that hakuna mzee tunamtaka, hakuna Kalonzo, hakuna Mataka. Just because they're on the sideline does not mean that they're with us. No, they're all same people. All of them out, let's start afresh. So it doesn't matter. One way or another, we are going to reach there. It's as everyone has stated, it's not a sprint, it's a marathon. So let's to lose hope. Tunachapwa, tunaenda tunapiga sipi ya maji, tunarudi tena kwa ground. Let us not stop. Tuendelee hivyo tulivyo. Na tutafika pale tunaenda. Asanteni.
Thank you so much, guys. What we are doing is called the battle of attrition. This is a strategy in warfare, you know, where the other side determines to wear down its opponent until it collapses. We are, but sisi ndo wananchi, like we're those who own the country. We are not going to leave Kenya. So our battle is a marathon. It is attrition. This is how the Afghanistans were able to defeat a superpower. United States, walitoroka, walikapo, 1 year. 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, bado resistant. Resist. Aye. wakatoka. So this is attrition. Not that it will take that long, but what I'm calling for is Maandamano every day, prolonged conflict every day until the opponent, they collapse. They don't have the sustenance. The state has the monopoly of violence. They have the military, the police, the weapons on their side. But we have numbers on our side. We have unity on our side. And we have the will to get the Kenya that we deserve. And I'm telling you, patriots, if we let this go, our children and our children's children will fight this battle. Like, will watakula hizi bullets. Because right now, the way Ruto is playing chess, this serious chess master is a serious tactician. And as I said earlier, akipitisha sasa bill ya extension of presidential term limits, hapo ndo utatoka kwa streets, hapo utasema tu ni sawa. Guys, wake up, don't lose hope. Now, it is now or never. Western, microphone is yours. Karibu kwenye mic, comrade.
Thank you, comrade Afro and fellow comrades on the platform. Salute all of you. We salute our fallen heroes. Their sacrifices are not in vain, despite what the political elite in Kenya are doing. Afro, Ruto is not a master chess player. You know, this politics is experimenting with something we've seen before. Moi did it, Kenyatta did it, invited KADU to the government. Mwai Kibaki did it, Uhuru Kenyatta did it. So it's rehashing things that have happened in the past and which have brought us to where we are. And we're saying, when you're confronted with an opponent, you don't exaggerate their capacity. That has got a psychological impact on you. You size them and you look at them and say, this, we're going to defeat this opponent. So he's not a master chess player. He's just rehashing things that his predecessors did and led us to where we are. But what is enduring is impunity. Impunity is enduring in Kenya. Because the 2010 Constitution was informed by what practices that were there before. And the practices that were there before were that the president could emasculate parliament by, you know, raiding, you know, backbenchers and, you know, dangling ministerial positions and those kind of things. And there were so many sycophants in parliament because you could make so much noise. And then once you're noticed, you're co-opted into the system as an assistant minister or as a full cabinet minister. Well, the 2010 Constitution wanted to do away with this kind of behavior so that parliament can properly oversight the executive. No, we are not moving. Individuals are still being raided. In fact, they're asking to be bought, and they're being bought. And we're going back to by-elections. So impunity is still reigning supreme. And then the same characters who are merchants of impunity, breaking the law brazenly, they call those who are resisting this impunity as anarchists. There cannot be a greater anarchist than the person who breaks the law, than the person who breaks the law despite having taken the oath of office to defend the law, to uphold the law. Warlordism. Raila Odinga espouses warlordism politics. Politics whereby people's lives are precariously dependent on the decisions of an individual. You know? So if this individual says we go left, people go left. If this individual says there will be no peace, there will be no peace. We're saying no. We are breaking ranks with that kind of politics. Where you form a political party, but this is not a political party. This is a cult. And you as the leader, you're a personality cult. So you decide who goes to parliament and who doesn't go to parliament. I ask, so if it's about inclusivity, or you want to bring, they have taken us into the morass of tribal politics. Okay, we'll discuss that kind of politics. We're not scared of it because it's very barbaric. So why would you, for instance, sack Owalo and bring some sycophants on board if you're talking about inclusivity. Owalo, somebody who stood by you when the likes of Mbadi, the likes of Opio and I didn't believe you could be president. Why would you bring such people on board and you dismiss Owalo, who stood by you, who campaigned for you? Can you see how cynical that kind of politics is? So that it makes every other Kenyan who rose up and went to cast their vote in August 2022 look extremely stupid. Extremely stupid. That you, like, you didn't know what you were doing. The same characters that made you think that they stood for something, here they are laughing at you. You didn't know. We just played these games. So we're saying this kind of retrogressive personality cult warlord politics, we're saying to hell with it. Going forward, to hell with it. So much so that don't be depressed. Don't be despondent. These people behave the way they've all along behaved over the years. They're scared of people. Their idea of inclusivity is sharing positions. That's how they define Kenya. When they talk about inclusivity, no, they're not talking about bringing healthcare within the reach of every other Kenyan, quality education, food security, jobs. No, their idea of inclusivity is very narrow. Personality best. I've got a ministerial position. I've got access to tenders. I can make so much money without work. These people have no regard for work. They don't. They have no what we would call Protestant work ethic. All that they do is to commandeer state resources to their own private ends and their cronies. So 2022 elections, ladies and gentlemen, fellow compatriots, did not afford us any options. Didn't. Before, I would hear, oh, people who supported Ruto must come and apologize. No, you can see. They have nothing to apologize for. The same way those who voted for Raila, you have nothing to apologize for. It is the politics that does not provide alternatives for transformation. And we're saying, no, going forward, no. We will reset, overhaul this politics so that we have got choices when we go to elections. Even if we don't have choices, we'll have a say on who governs, who rules, who makes decisions for us. Finally, Law Society of Kenya and lawyers. I think you may have heard they are talking a lot about the law. Can we have a referendum to recall the president? Can we go to the Supreme Court for some advice on what to do? I don't know, ladies and gentlemen, I don't know. Because these are not normal circumstances. You only invoke the law where people are acting sanely, and those who are in charge, those who are in power, actually have regard for the law and the constitution. Then you can invoke the law, say, look, the president, you make this decision. This decision is abnormal. We will go to the constitution. We will invoke the constitution, we'll go to the court and have an interpretation of this. But somebody who is perennially, regularly breaking the law, how do you think you can defeat that person by invoking the constitution? And why do you think that the judiciary does not have people who think like that president? What makes you think so? Well, you can get one or two judges who stand out from the rest. But I dare say, if you're talking about a revolution, even people are in the judiciary are scared of that revolution because they know some of them have been taking bribes, have been on the take, they've been making very dubious verdicts. And if you are talking about revolution, you're going to audit all those people. So why do you think in the corridors of the judiciary you're going to get people who will buy into your revolution? Whereas you want to get rid of the entire architecture, the entire establishment. The judges are part of the establishment. They are. So it is this, as Afrocentric says, the protests, the agitation, the numbers, the mass uprising. This is the only strategy that will bring forth change and transformation. There hasn't been the first so-called first liberation. The colonialists left, but they left us people who think like them. The so-called second liberation. Yes, we have multipartism, but we have got tribal politics. How is that multipartism working for us? We've got the same people like Raila Odinga who purportedly fought for multipartism, but they're reactionary. They're self-centered. They're narrowly pursuing their own economic and political ends. So what is that liberation all about? So this that we're fighting for will be the first final liberation that liberates the Kenyan totally civil liberties, economically, psychologically. We do away with sycophancy. You know, ladies and gentlemen, we have got a problem in Kenya. Sycophancy. You just get elected to parliament because you're a sycophant. You're just singing somebody's praises. You get elected as a governor, but you're a sycophant. You remain a sycophant. Goodness me. Why do we have 47 counties if all we have are sycophants? Popularly elected governor, but the president still summons you to Nairobi. Oh, my goodness. And we waste money on these people. So this rotten state, rotten system, is what we're fighting against, ladies and gentlemen, compatriots. Let's not lose focus. These people can do whatever they wish. They can appoint themselves to positions of power, but we're saying change is coming. The liberation is coming. This cesspit of tribalism, cesspit of corruption, cesspit of impunity, cesspit of personality cultism will come to an end. And I say, for those who have been referring to Raila Odinga's Baba, please stop doing it. You are exaggerating his influence in your lives. You are exaggerating his push, impact on your psychology. He's just what he is, a corrupt, nepotistic, an impunity merchant, and part of the old order, and all of them must go. Diva.
Wah, 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 wah. Hey, I love that submission. And I'm just going to give some good news, guys. You know me, I'm a very spiritual person, and I'm always feeling like I'm very led by God, and I like observing patterns. I think our ancestors used to thrive on patterns. It is through patterns they used to know that it's going to rain in this season. It's going to, you know, this is when people should be circumcised. Like, culturally, we observe patterns. And today, I am observing a pattern. The pattern is, I have observed over the past couple of protests, when the sun rises early, when the sun shines early, many, many people show up to the CBD. And I'm thinking, I'm going to take this as a very good sign, and I hope I'm going to see all of you guys in the streets. I'm going to for a meeting at 11, but by 11:30, I'm going to be done and in the streets with all of you guys. Back to you, Afro.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Powerful submission, Western, guys. Western is our residential political analyst. Powerful submission. We need to get done with this political elite. They are the same, one and the same thing. And moving forward, don't lose any gusto, reason to be on the streets. Kenya is our home. I'll give the microphone to Danny. Danny, Mike Niako, karibu kwenye space. Are you there? Danny, can you hear me? Danny?
Yes, sorry, I'm here.
Yeah, go ahead, mic is yours.
Thank you so much, Afro, and the co-host. Thank you for this amazing opportunity. Today, my heart is weeping for the 16-year-old that was abducted. I'm just annoyed. Why is that happening? And why haven't they freed him up to now? What are they even doing to him? I'm sure by now they know that he's a minor. So I don't know what they are still doing with Kiama. That boy should be back home by now. So we should keep on the hashtag of pushing for him to be freed and released. And even the rest, some people are still missing. We don't know where they are. So kindly, if you're here and you know someone who is missing, you can bring the name forward so that at least we can push for the hashtag for him to be released. Because clearly, they've even gone ahead to even start abducting minors, which is very wrong. So again, on that spirit, if you're not annoyed enough, I think you should be annoyed by now. It's a good day. Leo hakuna baridi, jua imetokea. So kindly, if you have time and you can be on the streets, please do so. And yes, the train has left the station. We shouldn't get tired. Let's keep on pushing. One day at a time, we will get there. I can't say that we've finished the journey or we've arrived where we want, but I can clearly say that we are getting there. One day at a time, one step at a time. Let's keep on pushing for the agenda. One day at a time, we will be there. We shouldn't give up. We shouldn't relent. Thank you so much, Afro.
Thank you, Danny. Microphone to Samuel. Samuel, you can hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Mike Niako, 2 to 3 minutes, tafadhali.
Thank you. So, fellow Kenyans, the war has already been declared. Declaration was read, and everyone knows we are at war. But we are armed with the Constitution of the Republic. And what we are asking, let people not call it anarchy or tell us that there will be anarchy or something like that, because the things we are asking are constitutional. Legal things, that is what we are asking. Who said that less than 1% ya Kenya ikuwe ndio ina own over 99.9% of all the wealth in Kenya? Wale wengine waende wapi? That is a place we have been subjected to be by this regime. And all this started when the handshake happened between Raila and Kibaki. That is when we lost, we started losing the trust. But after Uhuru and Ruto took over, hapo ndipo nchi ilienda. That's where our country left. Right now we are ruled by criminals, murderers, people who would kill a child. It's like, hatuna kwa kukaa. Ukitoka Africa, ukienda huko, unaweza uawe huko Marekani, Europe ama wapi, juu ya kukua mweusi kwenye ukiwalk kupita tu barabara ukiitisha what is yours, you are being shot. We are being terrorized everywhere. And this is not happening to Kenyans only, it happened kwa ngine Africa. What makes me more hopeful of our fight is because Kenyans, we are fighters. Tulipigana na mzungu akaenda, tukapigana na Moi akaenda. Even this one will go. But with this one comes change. The fall of Ruto comes change. Because our country has changed so much, the economy has grown, we ought to feel that change. That change, we have not felt it. Only few are the ones actually enjoying our labor. Very few people. And the reason why they are refusing to leave power is because they know they are playing with fire. Wanacheza na moto. Juhi katiba in a rules, and these laws are the ones that are being violated. And if we enforce this constitution on them, they know they will burn and they will run away from the country. We continue making it hot for them, and even after they leave office, we make sure that every stolen shillings, especially those like in a Eurobond and all that money, it is returned to the people of Kenya. And while you're together for the situation we are in, face the full extent of the law. Because there is no respect of... Ask yourself, why do they get to use the constitution on to their advantage? Ati mtu akibio, wanajua rights zao za vyama sana. They know this constitution article inaongea about uhuru wa vyama and all those. The political class of Kenya have known how to manipulate us. The constitution, the better side of the constitution works for them, And the harsh side of the law, it applies to the common mwananchi. Mwenye hana chochote, ndio unaona mwizi wa kuku anafungwa kifungo cha maisha. Lakini ule mwenye ameiba mabilioni za pesa, huyo mtu anaenda free. That is the Kenya we are getting rid of, and that is what Ruto must go means. People are subjected to poverty, to be made to think that only food that matters, that food is the only most important. Chakula sio cha muhimu, my friend. Kuishi ka heri ukufe kuliko kuishi ukiwa mtumwa. Kwanza kwa nchi yenu, nchi ambayo tunajua ilipiganiwa ikamwagiwa damu, and yet resources kiasi ya hiyo nchi ikigawa only few. Familia tunaweza count hivi, individuals we can count. It is time to show these people that we are the one who have given them power. And when someone has given you the power, thank you, finishing, someone giving you the power, they also have the power to take it back. So fellow Kenyans, we are at war. Read the constitution very well. Read that book. Keep telling your friends to get ideas if they don't have. And the war has just begun. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Yes, the war has just begun. That you have something to say?
Yeah, there's something that I've just seen, that the 16-year-old boy has finally been released this morning. Like 24 minutes ago, there's someone who posted.
Okay. Let's confirm that news, if he's really released, because we know we have these government bloggers who are be. I have to triangulate my news before I really put it out there. Make sure, hey, is this sourcing? Okay, it is correct. Before even last Tuesday, someone was sending me messages. Nairobi West Hospital is on fire. Where can I put it? Put it out. Nairobi West is on. I said no, because there's a lot of misinformation on these spaces, and they are trying to distort the truth. Number one, during war, truth is always number one casualty. Like once people discredit you and they know, hey, if I come and I hear from this person, there's no news. So we need to realize that government bloggers are trying to discredit and pass wrong information. So happy he's released, but let's all make sure that he's released. Kiyama, we are saying this morning, free Kiyama. He needs to be released. High school student doesn't need to see prison bars, doesn't need to be traumatized, doesn't need to have these mental issues right now, seeing the government torture him, beat him, and imprison him. That is uncalled for, and not the Kenya that we want. I'll give the microphone to Citizens Observer. Mike Niako, karibu kwenye space. Can you hear him speak? I can't hear him.
Me neither, I can't hear them.
Citizen, Danny, can you hear Citizen speak?
We don't hear anyone speak.
Citizen, please shuka chini uitishe mic tena.
Fix your mic. We can't hear you.
Ken, Mutwiri.
Yes, good morning, Afrocentric.
Morning, we can hear you, comrade, go ahead.
Pleasant partners. Yeah, so we have reached in a point whereby the political class has united against the people who choose them and who voted them to get into power and into those bigger offices. Tumefika mahali Ruto ametuletea war cabinet. Like the one by Tianyao, there's a guy in Tianyao, Prime Minister of Israel, formed to fight Gaza. We are the citizens of this country. We don't have guns. We have just our phones, maji, just play guns, flags. Then the political class has just united against us. So we shouldn't just strategize on how we are going to fight them, kwa sababu hatuchoki na haturudi na nyuma. our protests should be on a daily basis. Leo, kesho, kesho kutwa, Sunday, Monday, tunaendelea. Until jinga inaisha. How can Rex Masai die? A lot of people, those have died. Then you tulete Joho, ni kama tulikuwa tunampigania. Nobody of us was fighting for ODM. Bringing Raila in the government doesn't mean that there is peace. Hiyo si kumaanisha sasa kila kitu imekuwa sawa. Nothing is okay. Nothing is okay. Na watu wanalalamika online wakisema I don't know who baba, I don't know what. Which baba? Fuck that Raila Amolo Odinga. Which baba? Baba of what? Baba of who? Baba of who? Ni baba wa nani? Eh? This guy has been ameishi hapo kushindwa tu, akishindwa hivi anajoin government through an handshake kupitia mlango wa nyuma, then he started terrorizing our taxes. So we should strategize, tujue vile tunaweza leta everybody, kila mtu akuje Nairobi tuandamane huku, eh, mabasi yaelekee ya yote, all roads zielekee Nairobi zote, tukuje we spent a day or two or three in Nairobi, kila mtu. Yes, until this guy aelewe what you are saying is sisi hatutaki mambo ya I don't know coalition or government, eh? So uniting Kenya Kwisha and Azimio, what does that mean? Hii itasaidia nani? Eh? Hii itasaidia nani? The guy they have brought in the government, they are the same guy which were fighting them during 2023 protest. So that means ni kulipa wamewalipa, eh? And I have seen a lot of people like from Nyanza, areas huko pwani, naona wana hey, kusherekea eti Joho sasa kwa serikali, hey, so president amefanya kazi, which job? By the way, huyo Joho wanasema ameingia kwa serikali, sasa he is coming now to terrorize them. He will fuck them up, vile raisi ameishi kutu nini, kutufanyia. So unit against nini hawa boda boda, hawa watu wanalipa the goons. Kwani watu wa boda boda wamekuwa kina nani? They were the ones who voted this guy in the office, wakiwa wanasema oh asala tawala, asala tawala, kwa sababu aliambia boda boda mama boga I don't know what do, mwananchi wa chini. So the same boda bodas they wanalipa. The other day tulikuwa na maandamano, uliona wakilipa wanakuja CBD, and I nashukuru Mungu tulichoma boda boda kama mbili tatu hivi, na tulifanya kitu mzuri sana, cause how can you be paid upatiwe 500 then uwekewe mafuta ya sijui ni 2000 uambie tu eti ukavuruge maandamano. Boda boda guys, we are warning you, kama kuna boda boda kwa hapo, we are warning you, please stay aside. Kama uko na hiyo njia ya kupewa 500 then you are okay, please step aside, step aside, kwa sababu tutapatana na nyinyi town, mtakuja a number of 500, we will be like 10,000, 20,000, million of us, mtajua mjui. Boda boda guys, please msikubali kutumika. Musikubali kutumika hata kidogo. Ile maandamano ya Tuesday, nyinyi ndio mlileta ujinga. Then, my time is over. Nikimalizia, we should continue pushing the hashtag Ruto must go. Ruto must go. Then I should just be allowed to say, fuck you Samoa William Ruto, fuck the Azimio people like Joho, fuck Raila Amolo Odinga and those others, those shenanigans, the shenanigan people. Thank you.
Inject. actually, there's just so much that's happening right now, even on my ATL, because of what this guy, what's his name, Edwin Sifuna came out to the media houses this morning to say that ODM are not the ones who fronted those people, the people fronted themselves, the people who've been chosen as CSs. And for me personally, I am certain that all these things are just charades. You know how there's a way people always look for a way to distract you from what's going on.
Honestly, ODM itself must go. Kenya Kwisha must go. All this, we must have a complete overhaul. Actually, there is a guy, I have respected their comment so much when they said that. How do you expect for these people who already don't follow the constitution, they don't care about the rules of our land, how do you expect them to fall by through petitions to the judiciary? Because it's like the judiciary is singing their tune as well. How do we expect this situation to be solved amicably through following the law? It's not possible. Hiyo time ya kuongea, hiyo time ya kutuma petition na feel ni kama imesha, but we should still attack in all forms. Wase wa IT, kwanza wanafua kwa wanahakizi account za Ruto zenye ziko na 63 billion. If they can just hack those accounts, release those accounts ziingie kwa accounts, I don't know where we take the money actually, because pesa is not where the problem is, it's just that accountability. Because if it was accountable, tunaweza sema, iyo pesa yote yenye imeibiwa iko offshore accounts, iingie kwa NHIF, na wasia watitiwe for free, you know. I've even been wondering, wasi watu wako kwa street, kama wasi wa politics wanawa bribe na wanawa honga, mbona si tu si find a way to find alliance to make sure everyone who's been going to the streets to protest is part of like some sort of a database. Okay, hii ni theory. Hii ni theory, hata si lazima msikize sana. But what if everyone who goes to the street is able to, like with their picture and their placard, they're able to post on a certain place so that we send them money? Because money is not the problem. Some people are suffering with money. And other people have money. Hata tukua nasema, by the way, hata hii country, for example, tuseme, just in case it becomes, as they have been calling it, anarchy, and most of the institutions are put down. Money is not the problem. Most Kenyans are educated. Most of us are working abroad for different corporations. Their money is not being affected by what's happening in Kenya. We can figure a way to fund our rebuild. But this is the thing. Everyone must play their part. Kama we ni dentist wa Ruto, umweke cavity. Kama we ni... what I mean? Like, if we can find a way to systematically do the thing. The lawyers are injecting on their side. The transport people, nimeona kuna protest kesho. Everyone is injecting equally and with more violence. Like, I don't know, with more persistence. Like everyone else. That is what we need in this space. And I think I have realized that the secret to our movement and our revolution is love. Love for our country, love for one another. Me, I don't want people to suffer in this country. If we could have just NHIF set up, maze every day, maze tunaitwa harambe. Every day niko na wasani wananipigia wambo, nitumie do niko mgonjwa nahitaji kwenda hosi. That should not be the case. Ikama ni NHIF inafokuwa imecover for everyone. Hii story hapa ya kila mse ati every man for himself. That is some bullshit. We are the richest country. Okay, maybe there are richer countries than us in terms of minerals and things like that in Africa. But we should be the richest country in the world. You know, it is insane when you think about how the value of the dollar, the value of the colonial system is on gold. Yet the colonizers don't mine gold. My guys, unaona penye tunachezwa. Anyhow, Afro, endelea.
Yeah, I've just triangulated your news and seen for sure Kiama has been released. That is, he's been released on bond. If you see, I've pinned it in the Jumbotron, he's called Methusela Kiama Maina. Yani wanataka kutulia Methusela. Unajua kwa Biblia Methusela alikuwa nani? The oldest man who ever lived. Yani such young boys should not be exposed to the trauma that these police have underput him. He has already slept in courts. Imagine in your teenage years, you are taken by your state, incarcerated by your state, beaten by your state, and you already have a bond to your name by the state. I'm telling you, kweli tuko na nchi hapa. I'm telling you, Kenya Kwisha. These guys have literally lived up to their name. Kenya Kwisha. has said, Kenya, we need to take back our country. Anyway, I'll give the microphone to Boniface. Boniface. Ngich Mjamo, karibu kwenye mic.
Thank you so much, Centric. Nimekuwa na hint na account yangu on off, anyway. At last, nimepata chance ya kuongea. First, let me have some sympathy with the family, friends, and relatives who lost their loved one during those demos time. May God give them strength during these trying moments. Again, without forget for those injured, maybe in the hospital or home, we wish them quick recovery. Tunasema, I think the very high time we focus. Because nimeshangaa juzi jana after hiyo issue ya cabinet imeappointiwa nikapatana na mama ako hapo tu kwa bunge I do work there. So mama akasema sasa maandamano imeisha. Sasa Raila ameletwa ndani na ndiye alikuwa ameleta jinsi. I was mad. Venye niligombana na mama, I think kila mtu aliona ni kama sijui nimelewa. Because si ku imagine that narrative. It is Raila ndiye alikuwa ameleta maandamano ya Gen Z and kwa sababu amewekwa on board, now the country can. I think these voters sijui watasoma lini. I don't know until when Kenyans will come to realize what they want in this life. Because I think voters, they are so petty. Na wako tu, wako ile era tu baada ya wirubaru, wako hiyo era ya mama mboga, those nonsense narratives. They are still there. I don't know. I think tunahitaji kitu inaitwa sensitization about what is happening in this country, and especially to these unlearned people. Our mama zetu na nini. And I think Gen Z's and Merino, when you tuna push for this thing, because we are going to win. The only gift we can give those foreign soldiers ni ku make sure Ruto ameenda nyumbani with the whole regime plus now ODM. At least now hatuna mtu ya kuja kutudanganya SG, oh, I'm the best or what. We need to bring a very fresh blood. I was thinking in case iende tu mpaka ifikie 18 mpaka 2027 ndio tatawatu through vote. Sisi tunajuana, you know your mother, you know your father, those who are supporting this regime. Sisi, I can ask anyone, nyemelea ID ya huyo mama yako ama baba yako that 2 weeks to elections, itupe, just pige kura. If we can destroy 1 million votes, ya watu, at least we will bring change to this country. Because I'm really wondering what is happening. And let me tell you guys, ase niyo kushtuka siji yo nini, itiji baba amejoin nini ya serikali, sasa, saa hii, sasa maneno imeharibika. Ruto is a sure bet story to do with the second term. For your information, if yesterday 2 million people joined Kenya Kuisha government, the same time yesterday, more than 2 million people pulled out from this fake government. In the end, even 50-50. So don't think it's a to make overpowered and we remain focused and let us not relent on this thing. What I can assure you guys, we are winning. And I can assure you the guy is panicked. Ukiona zile vitu anafanya, the guy is a clueless. We were not even expecting him to behave the way I may behave. Ukiona anafanya mpaka changes kwa jeshi, jamaa amefika mwisho. The only thing inahitajika, push kidogo and the guy is out. Let us remain focused and I'm sure at the end of the day, tutaona mwangaza. Thank you so much, guy. I wish you guys good day. At the same time, I wish Kenyans at least to open their eyes wajue ni nini wanahitaji kwa hii maisha. Asante sana Afrocentric.
Thank you so much Ngich. Citizen, are you there? Observer, umerudi, mic yako ilikuwa na shida. Citizen Observer, can you hear me?
Afrocentric, unanisikia?
Nasikia vizuri, endelea, mic ni yako.
Asante sana. Acha niegeze gari kando alafu niongee. So thank you so much Afrocentric for this opportunity and the mic and the space. I'd like to take this moment to condole with the families who have lost their loved ones during this protest. Our hearts go out to you, and more so to the kid whom I saw
that he passed away in, was it Zimmarman, the grade 4 kid? Huh? Sorry to the family. We won't give up just because of you. So I come from Bomet, and I wanted to address this issue of Mutuetu. Our people in Bomet have been brainwashed so much so that they believe that Ruto akisema anything, he's final. I'm a farmer in Trans Nzoia, a small-scale farmer, and the so-called Mutuetu alituletea mbolea fake. And you can imagine, guys, if you're plowing, to say an example, I do farming for around 70 acres. You've spent more than 500,000 shillings to buy the fertilizer from cereal. Then a few weeks later, unaambua they are fake. Then you go ahead and spend another 5,000 to buy fertilizer from the shops now. And then you come and tell me again that the guy is Nimtuetu. We shouldn't be fighting him. No way. We have to fight Ruto and the entire system. He has to go. These people are scared. They are scared. Why? We know so much. We know so much, so much, so that we want corruption to end in this country. We know so much so that we understand the constitution in and out. That is what is really scaring them out. And that is the reason why they have joined hands and they are seeing the common enemy as the wananchi. I wanted to say that guys, we are on a hunt, and when you're hunting, you do not stop and start throwing stones at squirrels. This nomination that you see, oh, ODM, they are coming in, oh, Sijuinani, they are coming in, those are squirrels. Let us focus. Our focus is to remove Ruto and the entire system. We want a new change. We want an end to the corruption in this country. We want a system whereby someone from the minority tribe, let's say, who are the minority people in this country now, the Okiek or the Sengwer or the Hus, when they front a candidate leader, we should all listen to him. And then if we decide we are voting for that guy, we vote for him. Not because he's a Kalenji, not because he's a Kikuyu, not because he's a Luo or the big tribes. No, we want a country that works for everyone. This issue of ati tunaenda siju tunapeleko wa Saudi Arabia. I saw a clip where someone is telling me that they can't leave just because their contract has come to an end. No, we all have to work in Kenya. Kenya ni kwetu bana. Me, I've never dreamt of leaving this country to go work elsewhere. I'm so mad. I'm so pissed off. I've seen a poster where you guys have some guys have told us we should meet on 8th. We have to agree. If 8th is the day that everyone in the 47 countries are traveling to Nairobi, so be it. But in the moment, the protests have to keep on going. Thank you, Afrocentric. Remember, we are on a hunt, and our target is Ruto and the system. This is Squirrel Zingine to Wachane Nazo.
Thank you, Citizen Observer. Discipline, focus, that's what you're calling for. Ignore the squirrels to sipo. Tukianza kuanza kugombana hapa, kugubishana hapa kwa TL, manze, we will never make it, guys. All energies, all guns, all focus has to be right now on this corrupt, illegitimate government that is abducting us, killing us, throwing us in dump sites, bringing a lot of terror to the people of Kenya, to bring a lot of terror to our neighborhoods and our estates. Manze, guys, do not forget the last cries of that Kenyan before he was shot in the back. I mean, shot surrendering. Imagine, how do you know the kind of evil you have to be to levels of rage to shoot an armed man who is surrendering, who is pleading for his life, and to take his life away from him and throw him in a truck and dispose his body? That is what has been sanctioned by this Kenya Kwisha government, which has now been unholy union right now with ODM. Manze, what they were kwende, manze. Imagine, nifungulie, nifungulie, nifungulie. That's all we're asking, manze, like opportunities. We want opportunities. Every Kenyan who has amesoma and has a degree is looking for opportunities, and I say, nifungulie, 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 nifungulie. But this government is killing our dreams, killing our aspirations. Every entrepreneur, every businessman who is asking for loans, who is asking for affordable loans, anasema nifungulie, nifungulie, let open for us, we enter, we can be prosperous, all of us. Lakini gava have set up a system that only a few, less than 5% of Kenyans, less than 1,000 people, are Mudavadis, Railas, Kalonzos, Rutos. They only, it's just them and their families that are succeeding. And that is not the Kenya we want. I don't know about you, but it's no longer business as usual. It's no longer business as usual. Yes, academic, karibu kwenye space.
Hello, mnanisikia?
Ukisikia vizuri, endelea.
Afrocentric, first of all, nataka kusema, whatever I'm going to say here ni maoni yangu, and does not reflect maoni ya any youth whatsoever. Yeah, number one. It is high time, guys, to go in a room for what if. Very necessary in anything. As much as we are focusing on Ruto must go, we must also have a room for chances. What if, no matter how small they are, but we must have them. I'm not a prophet, but mark my words, in the next 2 to 3 months, the next thing itakuwa when Parliament ikirudi, ikianza sitting session zao after vetting the CSs, of which watapita wote. They will see on how to curb the article that allows us for free speech na maandamano. Mimi nimesoma kitabu inaitwa Shamba la Wanyama. The constitution was there, but overnight kakitu kanaongeza wajuu. So we have freedom ya kuandamana, which is the only thing holding us on the streets. It's a matter of time Ruto venya mishikana na ODM, and they have the numbers in terms of MPs. Ni kakitu tu wanaongeza pale, na utapata maandamano yetu ukienda kwa street ni kushikwa tu, because utakuwa unasikia we go as by the rule of law. Utasikia tu wamesema hata itisha license, which of which itakuwa ngumu kupata. Now that's what we say, what if. We are asking for Ruto must go. The man tunasema must go is planning for 2027. Mind you, he didn't appoint CSS. What Ruto appointed were campaign managers, strategic campaign managers. Ukiangalia, there's no way you can replace Professor Njuguna Ndongo with Mbadi. Atawe utajua tu hata madman can never do that. Why? Number one, Mdongo, si mtu anaweza kupea kura 2027. He's not a politician. But with the body, Ruto will go to Luo Nyanza with one card. Niliwapea pesa. Doketi ya pesa niliwapea ilikuwa yenu. Aya, number two, angalia Western. Hata kama tumesema we are tribeless, but it exists and we have to agree. Denial, tusikue nayo. As much as we are tribeless, we must agree we are going against a person mwenye atacheza tribal card. Western already had Paranya na kuna the speaker na kuna Mdavadi, which we must agree is strategic. Now, what if that's our plan? He is planning on 2027. What is our plan to counter that? What if he doesn't resign as we want him? And he goes to 2027 and advise again. What if? Plan yetu ni gani? Aya, number two. It is high time Afrocentric. We warn our youth. Tukienda maandamano. Tuwa warn against waziuliwe. Each of you here knows kama ukwa 2207. We are against Ruto. No amount of bloodshed itamfanya afpeane president. That man alichoma kanisa kiwa na watu. Hiyo, lazima tuseme sasa, it is us protecting our lives. It is no longer protecting our life. Hiyo nao munajua. It is protecting properties. So life, this is to protect. Number three, kuna what we call litmus test. Huko na open seats kwa iyo constituency ya Opiyo, Wandanyi, iyo Uguja na iyo ya Mombasa. Elite must test hata ya Ruto before ajue kama anaweza beba hii kiti ama hata beba, ilikuwa hii ya Kiamba. If he fielded the candidate and in UDA while he Raila and Uhuru fielded the candidate under Jubilee na akashinda. We should try to field a candidate as youth. Tuone, how strong are we? Tuone kama hapa Siaya, can we have a candidate who is not from ODM win? hiyo ni litmus test tutafanya. Tukishindwa hapo, tujue tu Ruto is becoming stronger in towards 2027. With the Raila on his side, with the Western and some parts on his side, as for him, how he thinks, is becoming stronger. Huyo jamaa anatafuta kampeni ya 2027. He's not looking for CSS. Aya, jiulize tu hivi. Swali. Leje inafaa kuwa open hapa mtu hata Afrocentric itakuwa lao nijibu. Do you think Ruto fired CSS because he had pressure from the youths, Gen Z, ama because he had a deal with the Raila to include him in the government? It's just a question I'm asking you. What was our demands akifire CSS? Number one, no recycling, but new and working phases. Number two, very simple, release hostages. Yama, our abduct, come hostage to seme, release them. Aya, what was the deal with him and Raila? Anataka kuingia kwa cabinet, watu wake waingia kwa cabinet, which required Ruto to fire the CSS, of which he fired them. And the reason he fired them, he said, listening to the people. Which people were they? Raila. Backing, now namaliza in 1 minute. But kurudi kupaka CSS, he recycled the people, but he gave new positions to Raila's people. So, do you really think he fired them because the pressure from us, or because he had a deal with the Raila? Fikiria hiyo. But one thing, Afrocentric in many spaces, advocate for the thing we call, what if? What if we advocate for what if, we will have plans. If this one fails, for example, what if we failed to enter Jkia to Lirudi CBD? That was a very good what if. Now, let's have a what if in every situation. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for your what if scenario. Yeah, but I always follow for burning all ships scenario. You know, there was a major who went in Spain who took over, I think, was it South America? Was it Mexico? And for him to motivate the soldiers, he told them, you know, he burned the ships. Because once you burn the ships, they landed from Spain. Wasipochoma hizo ships, watu wakafikiria kuna fallback plan. Eh, tunaweza rudi Spain, turudi, if we don't take over, if we don't conquer this, we will turudi back. So, it can be, you know, like a psychological war when you think that we're gonna plan B. Apa to sipu, And that's what I like about Anguka Nayo. Anguka Nayo is hakuna plan ingine. Hii ni kuanguka nayo. Ninaona, that's where we're going. But anyway, something to think about. And the whole space is listening to you. So everyone is thinking about it. Most of the decisions we make as a movement are made on the fly. So kick on the ground when you're on this, when you're in CBD, depending, we can never plan for meeting goons, we can never plan for meeting counter protests, we can never plan for bad weather. There are all these circumstances we make on the fly. So thank you for your points. I'll give the microphone to Quiet Riot. Karibu kwenye mic. Quiet Riot, oxymoron in itself. Uko hapo?
Hello.
Karibu, 2 to 3 minutes.
Hello.
Mic ni yako.
Asante sana. Let me time myself, starting now. Can you guys hear me clearly?
Yes, we can. Go ahead.
Fantastic. I want to speak to you, first of all, if you have lost someone, I want to wish all our comrades that have lost their lives, I want to wish their families condolences. May they rest in peace. And I feel like we as Kenyans should do everything we can to support these families. Not just the ones who have died, sadly, but also those who have been maimed. Some people are now unable to work. Some are unable to feed their families. And it is very sad. I want to speak to you if your material conditions have been affected greatly by this clamor for justice. I want to speak to you if you are immeasurably angry. I want to speak to you if you're tired of being taken for fool by the political class. I want to speak to you if you're tired of seeing minors being arrested and incarcerated overnight in jail. I want to speak to you if you're super sick and tired of seeing bodies in the morgue, and to add insult to injury, the body's nature in terms of their death are deliberately mislabeled by the police, by the state. It is so insidious using such a tired phrase as hit and run. Do you know how insidious that is? To imagine that a family is looking for a lost one who is probably in a mortuary somewhere. The family understands that this person left a certain place, say Kariobangi. The bodies in the morgues are marked as hit and run victims from Juja. Can you imagine the heartbreak? I am so angry. The recent appointments by the president are also terrible. They're the worst kind of people. He began by saying he wants to focus on fighting corruption, but the appointments are the face of corruption itself. Sifuna was speaking this morning on television, and all I heard was nonsense, semantics. The fact that ODM has not come out to expressly say they have partnered with this other party does not mean we cannot see they have clearly partnered. My time is almost up, but we're being taken for fools. We are being lied to constantly, and we are sick and tired of this soap opera that is insidiously deja vu, if you understand what I mean. Like, I feel like I've been through this before over and over again. And I love this upward swell because as young people, our only measure to change this country is to fight, is to keep protesting, is to go to the streets, is to demand for accountability, is to demand for the right crop of people to be put into our institutions. We demand better. Thank you for the time.
Thank you so much. Quiet record, powerful submission, very powerful indeed. I'll submit the yield the mic to Fozia. Fozia, are you there? Azenga, can you hear me? Fozia, are you there?
Wake up, people. Actually, Afro, I'm unable to add anyone onto the speaker's list, so it looks like that's your task today.
Okay,
yes, I can you guys hear me?
Yes.
Okay, what I wanted to talk about was when we started this movement, we had numbers, and that's a fact. We had numbers when we started because we had the people, we had influencers, and some of which were pushed to go to the streets because their followers threatened to unfollow them. Also, when we started, we had a common enemy, which was the finance bill. Everybody was against the finance bill. Everybody was rejecting the finance bill. Right now, the movement has taken a different turn, and we do not want Ruto. We are saying hashtag Ruto must go, but we are forgetting that this is a very tribalistic country, because right now there are people who are celebrating because there are people, Luo people, people from Luo land, kuna watu wenye wana celebrate right now juu mtu wao amepatiwa docket ya CS. You see, they don't care whether this person is going to work for the country or deliver. All they care about is mtu wao akona cheo, mtu wao is in government, mtu wao, like that pride of their person. And I feel like it's high time we need to educate people on like credibility. We need people who can work, not like people who are just there to represent my tribe. I'm a Luo, but I don't want somebody to be out there because he's representing me as a Luo. We don't want that. I think we are past that. And right now where we are, I feel like this tribalistic nonsense is supposed to end with us. this country has not had opposition in a while, because say 2007 people died, and then there was that handshake of Nusumkate, and then when Uhuru came in, there was another handshake. And I feel like what Raila knows how to do best is be in bed with the government. He doesn't care about me, he doesn't care about you, he doesn't care about any other person. But then that man has his diehard supporters. He has people who, like, here in Kisumu, utasikia mtu akisema, ah, baba amesema, Raila amesema. It's like we are worshipping this person, and it really gets me mad, because growing up, I've seen that happen. I had my grandfather saying it, that baba amesema, this is what is supposed to happen, baba amesema. So like, if he says jump, people jump. If he says sit, people sit. And that is the same thing alikuja nayo kwa hii alikuja nayo ku take over this the credibility of our protests. Alikuja knowing very well akona watu wake who would listen to him regardless of what happens. And right now Maandamano inafanyika hata hapa Kisumu, like we are protesting, but I feel like we are now supposed to focus in Nairobi, because Nairobi is the capital city. If we shut down everything in Nairobi, they will have to relent. And this thing of kuna watu wengine wanasema that let's wait for 2027, that is not going to happen, because for one, who is choosing? Nani anachagua the IEBC officials? Because if it's Ruto who is going to choose the IEBC officials, then this goes without saying that he's automatically going to win. He's going to do whatever it takes to grab that seat again in 2027. And if we relent right now, it's not going to be easy for us. Like tukiacha, you see, when we started tulianza with so much energy, tulianza with so much anger, but then watu wanarudi wanaogopa, because wengine wanauawa, wengine wanakuwa abducted. People feel like, oh, let's just wait for 2027. We don't see that the moment we decide to wait for 2027, we're giving them the chance, and they're really going to do us dirty, and there's nothing we are going to do at that point. Tukikaa tungoje. So if there's anybody, like, kama kuna tu venye mnaweza create awareness, like, educate people on how bad this thing is, because most people don't get it. I can see my time is up, but I feel like watu huku mashinani, they don't get how bad this thing is. So if there's a way wanaweza kuwa educated, that would be better. And yeah, Ruto must go. Thank you for the mic.
Thank you for Zia. We are overflowing.
My mouth is best.
Walter, mute your mic. Walter, mute your mic. Thank you. Guys, thank you. We are overthrowing these mentalities which plagued previous generations, which was psychophancy. Mr. our resident political analyst, Mr. What's his name? Shilayo spoke at length about it. Psychophancy. When Ruto say, when your kingpin says jump, you say how high. Those days are over. We have brains. We are educated. We are able to apply the force of reason to any policy being passed by government, to any bill passed by government. We're able to read and understand the constitution. That's why majority of these spaces for the past 6 weeks have been civic education. And we are asking everyone who understands any part of the constitution, like, explain it, explain the bill to your parents, explain why you're on the streets. And many a times we have seen youths who have been arrested articulating their rights, articulating why they're on the streets, to the point that they are being released. And that is that's the power of information. Information is power, because it empowers the citizenry. And there's nothing that a tyrannical, corrupt government wants than to muzzle the media, to restrict education. That's why they're hiking the fees in university. They want it just to be for a select few. wanataka tubaki wanyonge, but hizo siku zimeisha and we are going to keep injecting and applying pressure until this government resigns and quits. I'll give the microphone to Rev Bob Kwanya. Karibu kwenye space. Rev Bob, are you there?
Yes, yes, yes. Are you getting me?
Loud and clear, Mike Niako. Karibu, comrade.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Praise be to God. Now, I want to bring some few ideas to us. And to open our eyes that we are not going to be helped by a political class. And many a times when it's men of God, we know the mistake they do. Oh, you can't hear me. Now you can get me? Afrocentric, can you get me now?
Yes, we can get you, but you're breaking. You're breaking. But go ahead. Rev, unasikia Rev?
I may disconnect.
Oh, whispers. Microphone is yours until Rev gets here. Whispers, can you hear me? Whispers 254. Whispers anaongea?
Ni kama sauti yake mic iko na shida.
Hello.
Hello.
Grace, microphone is yours. Welcome.
Yes, thank you very much for this time. All I can tell you is the journey is long. We're only halfway. But I believe that you are going to achieve change that we want, so long as we focus and so long as we remain together. And you see, there was disunity among us at some point, and that is when the government did everything possible during that time to come up with a plan for them to take over what we were fighting for. But I want to encourage each and every person of you that we should support each other and we should leave this issue of tribalism. And in fact, I am disappointed that some of you are still talking about it here. Because if we start like Amalua, Makikuyu, look at what they did now in Ukikuyu, now Mombasa, we won't go far. So let us just remain tribeless as this thing started and let us focus ahead. Personally, right now, I'm writing a memorandum that I'm going to send to Parliament to bar Abraham Kindiki from seeking cabinet secretary again, given the fact that we suffered during that period of demonstration and there were some deaths experienced. And I'm going to send it today. So we should come up with plans in a way that going to Maandamano only will not help. Use the constitution, use Maandamano, use the word of mouth, use social media platform. Everything that you have, let it be your tool of war. Use your TikTok platforms, explain to people your views and what you think, and educate another person that is not aware of what is going on. Again, I would encourage, if we have this memorandum, 10 of them, 20 of them, it will cause a havoc in Parliament. And I know they will not ignore what the citizens of Kenya are saying. And another thing, let us just stop blaming leaders We know very well that politicians have their own personal interests. Personally, I have loved Baba. I only didn't vote for him in 2013, in 2017, but in 2022, he got my vote. But now I view things differently. So let us just not rub shoulders, let us not judge people, let us just stop pointing fingers, let us focus on what next, and let us encourage each other. Personally, I was so drained yesterday, I was so disappointed with whatever was happening, but when I woke up in the morning, I looked at the future, not now. And in every battle, you can win you've won a battle, but the main idea is winning the war at the end of it all. So don't forget, this is just divide and rule tactic to rule the country again. And it is you, as citizens of Kenya, to say no and stand for the truth. I won't say much because I'm busy, but that is one thing I really wanted to tell you. Thank you.
Feel encouraged, everyone. I think every situation of life is just showing us that everything is going to be okay. So don't feel so disheartened, guys. Things are going to be better. Every day we are actually, there is a saying that goes that it has to get worse for it to get better. But even the worseness is making it better for us. Like now, even Raila joining Kenya Kwisha is so that we can be able to get rid of the whole regime, not just the one that's in power, but also the opposition. So now we are the ones who are the opposition. So yeah, Afro, take it away.
I'll give the microphone to Grace. Your hand was up. Are you ready to speak, Grace? Okay, Samsi Magniako.
Good morning. Yes, I think for me, I have two things that I'll like to share with you guys, because the way pale tunaelekea naona mambo inazidi kuwa mbaya, but tumeanzisha vita na lazima tuimalize, because you see yesterday the government wamekuwa confirm wameshikana na Raila ametusaliti. That's point number one, and we agree with that, because GNC started a movement ambayo tumesema hashtag Ruto must go, na lazima atoke na the full cabinet, atoke na deputy president wake. But now wameshikana na Raila, they will start fighting us back, and we need to be strong. That's point number one. Raila ametusaliti, na hiyo tunaweza sema fuck you Raila, because Raila ametusaliti, hatukuwa tuna expect kitu kama hiyo Raila anaweza tufanya. Point number two, I think is high time endakana tuji plan vizuri, because we need to start accessing the CBD, because me I live in Mombasa, but wakati ya maandamano mi uteremuka always, me been in Kitengela several times, sometimes in Nairobi. So inatakana tujipange vizuri, tujipange kama ni kuprotest, to protest CBD, to protest all over in Nairobi, so that the all business in Nairobi ikwe shut down, so that these people, they can understand our language, because the only language of these people they can understand now is violence. Violence by what? Protesting in peace, walking in the streets, raising up our flags, shouting hashtag Ruto must go, plus is all cabinets. So I think tukifanya hivyo tutaenda pale. Then yesterday nikiguzia kidogo niliona, I think it's Kimuzi alikuwa ametweet amesema, is it Kimuzi? Yes, if I'm not wrong, it's Kimuzi alikuwa ametweet amesema, these people vile wameshikana na Raila wataanza kutufight, na tukiishiwa na nguvu ya kutokufight saizi tutalemewa, wataanza kutukidnap, mtu fulani anajulikana ako pale fulani, wanaenda wanamkidnap. So I think sisi natakana sijui to raise up vizuri na tuamue. Tuseme this time round sasa tumeamua. Like ile protest ilikuwa 25th. Ilikuwa protest ambayo ilikuwa sawa kabisa last month. Natakana tushikane sasa turudi kwa hiyo. Kwa hiyo yeah, the exact number ambayo tulikuwa hiyo wakati. I think tukishikana hivyo tutakuwa sawa because nowadays people tunaongea kwa space, tunafanya nini, but kwa ground watu wenye wanatokelezea ni less. So unapata watu wenye wamefika kwa ground pale kufanya 1 2 3 na walemea. Why? Because the crowd ambayo iko pale iko less. Hatuwezi kuachieve movement yetu ile ambayo tunataka. So I think we need to come together na tushikane. When we say Ruto must go, wacha to mean Ruto must go. Yeah? Cabinet nani au wote wenye tunataka watoke, to mean lazima watoke. Because tutaongea lakini tusipofanya action hawezi elewa. These people wanaelewa tuna action. Lastly, my condolences to the Zima people. I had the voice of that guy, the boy akisema, oh, open for me the gate, and then finally unapata makarao wamemshoot na amedai. Manze si poa, na ni mtu kwa nchi yako. We have freedom to talk, we have freedom to walk, we have freedom to do anything that we want to do because tuko kwa country yetu. But when you find that's, I think that is a Gen Z guy ana shout afunguliwe gate na kauliwa. So man, kama ni kushikana, tushikane tu pamoja, tufanye kitu. Tuache kuangalia Raila, tuache kuangalia Ruto. Mimi nashangaa mtu akisema ati President Ruto. Who is Ruto? Yeah? Ruto is not the president of Kenya for now. Yeah? Because tunajua watu wa Ruto kwa space wanasikiza wanafanya nini. But the way our people are suffering now. Yeah? We'll not allow that. So please tushikane. I know my time is out, but tushikane, tufanye 1 2 3. I think tufanye kitu ya maana. Afro, back to you.
Thank you Samizi, thank you for your submission. I concur with you, and I've kept on saying this on Spaces, the most dangerous individual to the movement is not Ruto, is not the Ruto Raila alliance, is not the politician or the yes politicians or the thugs with rungus on the streets. The most dangerous individual right now where we are as a movement is the moderate Kenyan. By the mean, kuna shida na the moderate Kenyan who are not radical enough to take to the streets. They want to go back to business as usual. They are the same ones who are telling Gen Z's, stay home, don't go home. Unaona huwa mekufa, unaona mekufa, do not go home. Guys, please mute your mic when you're on the space. Please, space, etiquette. They're the ones who are telling Kenyans, please, stay home. Let this guy, patia Ruto time, atengeneze inchi. The moderate Kenyan who is saying, oh, guys, kwani mkona, what next? Has the IBC been constituted? Mkona agenda gani leo kwa streets, mwenye kwa streets? The moderate Kenyan is the most dangerous individual. These are the reason why the slaves in America were slaves for 400 years. This is the reason why we are called the Dark Continent. This is the very same reason why we can never achieve Singapore, South Korea status when we have the resources, because we want to go back to status, we want to go back to business as usual with thugs who are ruling over us. They are not radical enough to get on the streets, and that's what Samizi is saying. Guys, when we say go to the streets, everyone pour on the streets. Please be radical enough to change your country, because I'm telling you, if we show up there, just 2 million Kenyans. Nairobi, the statistics show we are 5 million. I believe, last time I checked, 5 million census put us at 5 million in the Nairobi area. Tokyo, if we just come, 1 million, 2 million people, this government will fall that same day. It has happened in other countries. It has happened in Egypt. It has happened in Philippines. It's now happening in Asian countries. Guys, we can do this. I'll give the microphone to Whisper. Whisper, you're here.
I think on another perspective, let me just use the word hate. I just don't like it when someone comes off from a tribal perspective. our generation has decided from now it's all about ideology. Kama wewe unakuja kujibamba ukiwa job, jitoe. Period. We've seen what is going round that Raila kita maandamano, baba amesema. He has his own interest, clearly. Sisi ndio tunajua Kenya tunafeel. Watu wanakuja wanapewa maso. Me, I hope. Come next election, bana, we are not going to forget because hakuna nguvu ya kuendelea kwenda maandamano. We need to make this change today. We can talk now, but we need to actualize it and know that we are never going to stop. We have to remind even our folks. Kuna maparents, mpaka wanaambianga watu wao, tunavotia huyu. And you still listen to it. Hauna job, hauna kitu yote. You see an MP saying ati hakuna, ati unapewa basari 3,000 bob to a child. School fees ni 30k. Hiyo inasaidia nini?
Hey, can you hear whispers?
No, I even thought it was just me.
Oh,
can you hear me? Yeah.
You went silent. Go ahead.
No, I'm saying, like, if it doesn't hurt you, guys, that we actually have fools for leaders, guys who can wake up in the morning and just speak the way they want to without being accountable, someone comes off anaongea something. Yani, we sat down and voted. People voted for someone coming in with mambo ya wheelbarrow, mambo ya wanaitwaje, mama mboga. Yeah. Saizi iko wapi? It's the same thing. We are going round. So, as of now, let us shy away from this ideology, this is my tribes guy, this is my who, my ideology. There's a powerful statement that if you want to ever divide Africans, divide them along tribal lines. If you want to divide an African further, add religion on top of it. Angalia, how many churches do you have? Who are the fools that support the churches, that support politicians most of the time? Pesa ina flow happy. Instead of inside the economy, we borrow and tunaweza sustain. In reality, I don't think I have anything I would say that is structured, but mainly I took watch news in 2017, period. My news is on Twitter. Because kila siku naamka nimekasirika, kuna watu wanaouana. If you had wind of everything during COVID, families were killing each other because hakuna do. Watu walikuwa wanajinyonga because hawana direction in life. But even our media and our fault, if someone has no sense, mbona umpatie ya time ya kuja kuongea kuwear out opinion yake ya upuzi? So kindly, we as brothers, hii age group yetu bana, na the other age group sahau, hao ndio watu tunataka kutoa. So kindly, let us forge forward, tuache kufight against each other ati kuna news imetokea, sijui kuna nini. I know, tunajaribu kuseparatiwa ama kuantagonized, but let us forge forward. So, thank you. That's all from my end.
Thank you so much, Whispers. MMP? MMP, can you hear me? KOT Sonko? Kwa kitu kusema? Just kia sauti yako leo. Hey man, I can't hear. I see you guys unmuting, but I can't hear you.
I cannot hear the host. Who is the next speaker?
That chick, tell MMP to go ahead.
MMP, are you there? Can you hear us?
Yeah, I can hear you, but I can hear you very well. Can you hear me?
Okay, please go ahead. Yeah, we can hear you well.
Yes. So, yeah, first of all, my condolences to those who've lost close people. But I'd like us to just actually be honest with ourselves and to accept that there's a group of people who are and have always been very ignorant, especially that age group of our parents, and sometimes even people of even guys who are in their 40s and 50s right now, unfortunately, and they just lack the knowledge to make like a sane decision. That's why you find they get so excited with such appointments of people of their tribe or their party, as opposed to thinking about the facts, like what happened yesterday. But the thing is, fortunately, the majority of the people are now the younger people. And the dynamics are very, very different. And the younger people, who are the majority right now, are very connected, and they're like one team. And that's why you find someone like Ruto and his allies, they're scared. Like right now, it's basically they're basically trying to come together as the older generation who have relied on tribalism to try and kind of mute the younger generation, which will definitely not work as long as us guys, the younger people, in fact, not us guys because I'm 45, but as long as the younger people stand strong with what they believe in, these guys are actually no match. So my advice is continue with the pressure, both on the streets, on social media, address all the issues as they arise, shoot down all the unacceptable suggestions or decisions that these guys come up with that are useless, and take advantage of these spaces like what you guys have today. Because with all this stuff, we make ourselves very, very powerful. And as individuals, we should not look at how many people were we on the streets today. As long as you as the individual, you were there, you did your part. So as long as you have gone out of your way, even if you're two guys, like many times I've voted for people where some of my colleagues tell me it's a wasted vote. But for me, I do it because I say, you know what, me, I'm voting for the person who I think is right. Even if the guy gets 80,000 votes at the end of the elections, as opposed to a guy who won with 7 million votes, at least I was principled. So let's stay focused. We stay together. We shouldn't think about this. It's like they're diverting. They're using this to divert our attentions. When you find these guys, they're ancient. They're aging. They don't see what the younger people see. Their way of thinking is completely different. It's like for me, when I discuss with my kids, their way of thinking is completely different. And the thing is, as a parent, I've started to accept that I should not limit them, because they are going to see something that I cannot see. And that's what Ruto is failing to do. He's not seeing that there are people who are seeing things maybe he's not even seeing. Yeah. He's just basically an old, insane guy. So you guys continue the pressure. Don't stop. And all the people who are involved, whether it's in the protests, whether it's musicians who are singing songs against these guys, or actors, even the guys who are sending funds to help people who are in hospital or bereaved families, let's continue doing that. So that's just my point for today.
Thank you. Thank you so much, MMP. Now, walituambia tunakuja kwenye barabara kama tuko na iPhone, kama tuko na maji ya chupa, na tuko na nini ingine, that chick? Ya tatu liko gani?
KFC.
Very good. With that, Father Madu, let us give time a coffee kwa Mr. Andy with the profile of KFC. Karibu KFC kwenye mic, KFC himself. Andy, send me what your intro
card. Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yes, but your background, you have a lot of background noise. Please get into our silent
division and talk. Yeah, I'm at work. I'm sorry. I don't know whether that one is going to interfere with my submission. But I can be heard. So, first of all, I'm really grateful for this opportunity. My submission for now is that.
Can I be heard? Speak louder. We can hear you. Overpower your background noise.
Yeah, okay. Can I be heard now?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, thank you, Afrocentric, for this. My submission for now is that my condolences, first of all, to the families who are bereaved during this tenure. And this is just a confirmation that we are all there for them, and we are all here with you guys. Who are bereaved because of this particular movement that you have. The second point that I wanted to talk about is that we all know that this generation that we are here right now, that is the Gen Zs and the millennials, it's a generation war that we are now trying to castigate here. And the war is against the bad governance. We are not fighting anybody, or we are not trying to do anything with those who are in power, but their bad governance is what has led us to this kind of movement. And we are here to, we all know actually that the political class has been having nothing to do with its people. That is now us, and their bad governance and whatever interest that they have been having that doesn't include the youth and doesn't include anybody who voted for them has now brought us to whatever circumstance that we are now here. The other thing is that as much as everything is going on, we need to mobilize our youths because kwanza tumekasirika sana, mimi niko Siaya. And here in Siaya, it has been really difficult for the lives of people to go to the street as of last Maandamano that was supposed to be happening on Tuesday. We did everything, we wrote placards, and out of nowhere, nobody attended anything. Everything just went silent. It came to the realization that there are rumors saying that, but Siaya, they are not Jesus in Siaya because in Siaya they have their youth leader is Odinga. I really came to realize is that thing true or what is going on here in Siaya. That one really puzzled me a lot. The other thing that I'm trying to put out here today is that Raila, as a leader, he adapted this movement. Yeah, 30 seconds, please. Raila, as a leader, adapted this movement to sanitize his friend, and they call the political brother, that is Ruto, and also to reward his psychophants in the ODM. And as opposed to this thing that happened, I would encourage all of us to go and listen to what Lee Njiru said about these politicians. And the hashtag that we are here in is that Ruto must go, and we should remain fearless, tribalist, and also leaderless for now, because we know everything that we are having in the future is really at our hands as for now. Thank you so much, Afrocentric, for this particular time.
Hey, thank you, Andy. We have heard your message through. Hey, there's a lot of background noise. But thank you for your message. You guys, if you're on the request line, if you're on the call, please bear with us. I'm trying to get through the line as quick as I can. I'm choosing randomly whether you have two followers, whether you're a blue badge, whether I'm just picking anyone, because this movement is for all of us, and we all have to append our voices to this movement and keep the conversation going. That's more important. Remember, today, Occupy CBD. I hope you're on your way to town. The space won't be lasting too long. We try not to space when we are having Maandamano. We try to just synchronize our thoughts together and just know where our rallying points are. Right now, it is CBD. I believe we'll be marching towards Harambe House, the president's office, to picket peacefully according to our constitutional rights. Na nyinyi NIS mnatusikiza ma spies, mupeleke hizo news, mweke hizo matrack hapo na mweke ma fragrance of freedom. Mkwe tayari. You are the ones who are anarchists. You are the ones who are attacking us. You're supposed to protect us. Mnatupiga. Siku zenu a number. Na tunapiga. I wish there was a place in Kenya tukipata uhuru yetu tuweke kila mtu ambaye unajua ako napiga. Because they're going to enjoy the fruits of our fight, you know? See ati when we have this social justice and constitutionalism and rule of law, and now we are